Hi guys, Mike here, one go ShortPlay, and today we are playing Asterix and the Great Rescue on the Sega Mega Drive. Not sure I played this one either. But I love the Asterix arcade game, you know, the brawler. But it's a brawler, and I love brawlers. That music isn't very Asterix, is it? Not really. And those effects are unnecessary. Oh jeez, it's nice. Again, Amiga-y instruments though in that music. Yeah, we know the Asterix story. We don't know what our quest is. Ooh, Asterix or Oblix? Asterix or Oblix? I'm gonna do Oblix. Let's give Oblix a go. This great rescue. Asterix. I don't know what I was about to say then. I had something in mind, it just went. Okay, anyway, when I was a kid, my mum used to work for St. Helens Council, and sometimes she couldn't get babysitters, and she'd take us to, I guess it was some kind of youth centre thing, where she worked from, and I don't know what it was, council building of some sort, and they had a library there, and in that library, because it was a youth thing, did that owl just hit me? I do believe it did, the swine. Oh man, don't die. Cool. I don't know what that's about. I think that's a celebration for getting to the end of the level. Yay! Whatever the quest was, brilliant. Let's have Asterix now. There was a point to that story. That's right. They had a library, and in the library, they had a shed load of Asterix books. And I've never been a big reader. All right, I've read quite a few books in my time. But, how do I get that crab? No, that was death. Okay, I'd rather get hit by the crab, I think, than die. Yeah, I've never been a big reader, and the books that appealed to me most in that particular library were Asterix books, because they were essentially graphic novels. I'm taking a hit every time. Oh, I see, you can throw stuff. I see, every time I hit a platform, I'm taking a hit. That's a weird little pattern for the water, isn't it? The waves. Path. Love Asterix. Yeah. And I think between us, my brother and me, basically read our way through pretty much every Asterix book there was at the time in the 80s. I'm guessing. I think there were some more written later, weren't there, that were far inferior. That's the word. Far inferior to the other ones. But I should have done a path. There we go. Path. 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 Oh, there's no path needed there. But I do need a path here. Yeah, and they were awesome. I mean, I didn't get a lot of the humour. I've since read the first one. Although I don't think I missed much. Oh man, something's up here. Yeah, and it was great. And that was my point, really. I love Asterix. I love the sort of consistency of the artwork as well. Okay, I could go into detail about what I love about Asterix, but I'm not going to. It was very good. Very good books. It was very good books, was Asterix. I'm going to use Oblix here and see if he does any better. And I've ever since had a bit of a soft spot for Asterix. I've recently started buying the books again. Well, I say buy, I never owned them. We had them at the library, but I started buying them recently to read them all in order. And I've got a little one on the way, so when he gets a bit older, he'll get to appreciate them too. Or completely ignore them. It's totally up to him. If he doesn't like them, I'm not going to force them on him. Oh, I see. Look, that's a platform. I thought I saw a platform forming as I died before. I'm in trouble here, aren't I? I am in trouble now. I've got no path left. Oh. Where? Okay, I think I know what to do now, though. We've got to get a platform path. A platform path. You know what I mean. We've got to throw a thing that makes a path that actually makes a platform. I think if we pull down and do it, we might be able to get a top. We'll find out shortly when we get to the end of this level. So those bottles obviously contain path. And by path, I mean those little round things. Jumping path. Jump path. Oh, there we go. I don't think I can make it up there, can I? If we get a bit further back and do a path. Oh, we're going to have to go for it. Oh, no, it disappeared and was too high. Yeah, we might be in trouble here. Okay, we've got path. Oh, time out. I know what to do. I just can't do it. Asterix. Come on, Asterix. You're the smart one. Help me out here. That music's just not Asterix at all. None of this music is Asterix. While it's got a certain amigury charm to it, it's definitely not Asterix. Okay. I think the problem is going to be getting those platforms set up in the right place. Where's me? Aha, you push it up on the button. Ah, no, I've done it again. I pressed the wrong button. Get out of the water. Oh, man. Oh, does this suck or what? Continue. This should be dead easy. It's really frustrating. It's going to keep pressing the wrong buttons as well. I'm not enjoying this game. Much as I love Asterix, I have to say I'm not having fun. I think once I get the hang of the buttons, jump is A, hit is B, and path is C. I'm sorry, it's not. I don't know what it is. It's a marble or something. It just says path when I hit them. I think when I hit them it says path as well. But I'm so wrapped up in the whole moment of it, I never noticed when I hit them. But when I throw the little ball. Okay, so we pull down. Ah, no. Pull down. Pull down. That's not working now. I think we've just got to run out of path. No, pull down. Ah, push up. Let me throw that. A is jump. Let's do this right. Dodge the fist. Jump on the platform. Yes! We're going to Rome! Oh, you what? That's just cheap. That is cheap. I've had enough. That was Asterix and the Great Rescue on the Sega Mega Drive. So I find it hard to say the word great in association with this game. It's not very good. Thanks for watching.